All right, so today is part 6 or 7, the sword of the spirit. And what the sword is God's word, the Bible. We use it by saying Bible verses when the enemy tempts us. So, you know, there are times, like I was talking about, we have the shield of faith, and that's all we have. We're just blocking, you know, everything from life, but we don't have the word to back it up or to say anything, you know, to also encourage us. You know, we can have a shield when people talk about you, I'm like, oh, that's all right. Say what you got to say about me or anything like that, but you got to have the word to back it up, to encourage you, you know, to be able to withstand anything. I mean, we look in 1 Samuel 30 and 6, you know, David was very distressed, you know, with life. At that point, it was just like almost wanting to give up, but he encouraged himself in the Lord. You know, there are scriptures that, you know, that's why we remember these, to be able to encourage ourselves. 1 Corinthians 10 and 13, it says, the temptations in life are no different from what others experience. And God is faithful. He will not allow the temptation to be more than you can stand. When you are tempted, he will show you a way out so you can endure. So what is God saying? God is saying that no matter what temptations come in life, temptations to cut somebody out, you know, tell somebody off, you know, your boss, you know, somebody you work with. You know, somebody saying something about your kids, you know, the bus driver, you know, that road rage person that, you know, cut you off or anything like that. You know, there's always a way, you know. God will always give you a way of an escape to be able to endure it. And what is God doing? I mean, God is just trying to build a better you. You know, he's trying to build spiritual character. You know, and I say, you know, and I always say that we never stop, you know, learning or growing, you know, in Christ. You know, even as much as patience as I feel like I have, you know, there are still times where it's kind of, you know, pushed to the limits or anything like that. But, you know, that is just God saying that, you know, that I'm only human, and to continue, you know, trying to get better every day, you know, work on what I can do, you know, because there's going to be times that, you know, we are going to be tried. You know, we're going to be tried at a higher level. But again, God said there's always a way of an escape. You know, and that's why, you know, I try to study and read so I can be able to, you know, have the word, the sword of spirit, to be able to give that to others that need it. And, you know, one of the greatest compliments that I get is when people say, you know, that's exactly what I needed, or you always know the right thing to say. And I just give God all the credit. You know, that's why I do what I do, so I can continue to be a blessing towards others. A couple other scriptures that will help you too with life. 2 Peter 2 and 9. If this is so, the Lord knows how to rescue the godly from trials and to hold the unrighteous for punishment on the day of judgment. So God is always with you no matter what. 2 Thessalonians 3 and 3. But the Lord is faithful, who shall establish you and keep you from evil. So God has established you even when you feel like, you know, you're falling, or, you know, you're, you know, you need God. Philippians 1, 1 and 6. This is one of my favorites. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work and you would carry it on to completion until the day of Christ. So what is God saying? When God said he knew you in your mother's womb, he said that he will finish what he started in you to make a better you. You know, like, and that's why he continues to love us, and we have grace and mercy, because he knows how we're going to be at the end, you know, and continuing to work, you know, because of our heart. And so I leave you with this. 1 Corinthians 1 and 8. It says, he will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of the Lord Jesus Christ. Firm to the end. So you ever remember when you first started riding a bike and your parents were there with you, or your mom or your dad? And, you know, that was that first time you were learning, and they kind of, you know, were walking with you, you know, while you were riding. And then they let you go. And that first time you may have failed, but you got back up. But they weren't that far behind you. You know, they were always there with you. You know, so when they saw you, they keep trying. And then you look back and you see that they're there. That's how God is. God is always there with you no matter what. So, you know, even on that bike. And it's, as we continue to get better and better, they're always there. And God is always with you. So I just wanted to leave you with that and be a blessing. And then give my daughter Samari a chance to say something. Bye. You want to say anything to him?
Well, when I was trying, I fell. Well, I scratched, but it was little, but it didn't hurt.
Okay. Did you get back up?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was scared.
He's playing us a part.
Hi.
My dad butted me over.
Excuse me.
I got back up.
I fell yesterday. He had a game and I twisted my ankle. But it's feel better today.
I was sore from track for a few days. I'm not sore anymore.
I was playing at the park with my dad. And then I got in his way and he bucked me over. And I got right back up.
Well, I know that my plant wasn't growing for a few days, but then God helped me grow it, and then it started growing.
All right, y'all. It's the word for the day, so everybody has something to say. God bless and love y'all.
Bye.
Bye.
Good night.